Hot Rod Hunter Richard Rawlings and Master Mechanic Aaron Kaufman embark on a build for a racing legend.
56 Nomad, guess who for? Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Hell yes.
Okay, we got a call from Dale Earnhardt Jr. He says, I like your Gas Monkey style. I want you to build me a good road trip car. My dad always had Nomad station wagons. I'd like to have one of those. And he gave us 10 days. 10 days. If you want a road trip car, 56 Nomad's probably a good place to start. Found a two-owner car out of Colorado.
The cool thing was Richard finally bought us a car that didn't have a lot of rust in it. What an awesome car. We knew Junior would want to have a nice paint job on it. So we cleaned it, stripped it all down chemically.
I asked Junior, I said, well, what kind of colors are you thinking? He goes, man, I like my Diet Do 88 car. Just throw something together that looks about like that. So here you go. This green doesn't make a statement. I don't know what does.
While Casey was painting, we were preparing our motor and transmission. See, it had a 265 in it, which ran okay, but we wanted something reliable because this was a journey car. So we called Scott and Dickie, and we got a ZZ4 crate motor with a warranty even. You just drop it in, ready to rock and roll. It's an excellent replacement for practically anything, especially 56 Nomad. Backed it up with an overdrive transmission, and to keep that thing cool, we used a Ron Davis radiator. Now that we've got all the fundamentals in place, we had to address the stance, the attitude of the car. And if the color wasn't enough attitude, we needed to get it lower. So we replaced all the bushings, ball joints, and put a lot shorter springs in it to get this thing as close to the pavement as we could. The original wheels might have been okay, but it didn't match the color of the car or the stance. So we put 18-inch Rocket Racing chrome boosters on it. First, I thought maybe the chrome was a bit much, but after we got this car put together, we realized we still had 3 pallets of trim left to put on it. So these wheels complement the car incredibly well.
Now comes my part. I gotta go argue with Sue. I gave her 31 hours and 59 minutes to do the full interior. You know what? She pulled it off. Like, it looks great and it's comfortable. Of course, it's not just about the destination, it's about the journey. One of the other things you have to have with a 56 Nomad that not a lot of these cars came with was air conditioning. I mean, it's hot down there in North Carolina and it's hot here in Texas, so we threw some AC in there and really killer Kenwood sound system. Now what are you gonna do? Grab your buddies, jump in the car and go down the street? Not without cup holders. I'm telling you, you gotta have cup holders. Wow! Now we're ready for a road trip. This is what this is all about. If Chevy Chase had this car back in the day, he would've went to Wally World, and they would've been open.